at them a couple times. Well, to me, the first threshold for this has to be accuracy, and second, maybe who it offends. And I think WBUR is on very firm footing with this. I mean, the term is legitimate. Now, whether it offends a group, you know, we've been through this hundreds of times in the past with abortion terminology, mm-hmm. about foreigner. I mean, I remember when Ted Turner banned the word foreigner from his air because who's foreign? You know, it's an international organization. So that, to me, is the primary threshold, whether it's accurate. And basically, a lot of news organizations have thrown alien out completely. So, I mean, that has worked. There has been some pushback on things that are found offensive, but if it's not offensive, it's legitimate.
You know, I have to say, I think the setup piece frames this perfectly, which is that illegal alien, or just calling somebody an illegal, really is offensive. And I think some of these other terms, like undocumented worker, or one of the ones I ran across was economic refugee. That is political correctness, mm-hmm. not accurate description. I don't really have a problem with illegal immigrant. I think it's neutral, and that's what we're trying to do in this situation.
In the past few years, there's actually been a lot of work at Franklin's. The Republican pollster has been pioneering on this stuff, looking at how people respond to different things. And so he will advise particular Republicans, whether you say global warming or climate change, whether you say, you know, pro-life or anti-choice, yeah. right? How do you phrase these things for maximum impact? But I have to say, I'm with Dan on this. You know, if somebody is driving and does not have a license, I'm sorry, but they are an illegal driver. Mm-hmm. I mean, maybe we don't call them that, but they certainly are. And just to say somebody is an illegal immigrant, it's not saying that they shouldn't, you know, get amnesty. I mean, it's not saying what your position is. In fact, I worked for a year in L.A., for a nonprofit group, and a lot of those kids wanted the Dream Act to pass because when they were 2, 3, 5 years old, they had been taken over the border. And I mean, they didn't have anything to do with it. They grew up as Americans, but they were not citizens. They could not go to college. Or if they could go to college, they had to pay for it all themselves because they couldn't get any of the loans anybody else could get. It's not passing a judgment on any of those things, but if you are here and you don't have the proper documentation, I don't see why you aren't an illegal immigrant.
You know, this is the struggle over language. This happens all the time.